moving to the fourth step of meditation or mindfulness. First step, we did it. And the first step is most challenging, when the mind is always outside. It creates the world of its own. It is the mind that moves outside, creates the world of relations, possessions, in time, space, and objects. When you wake up in the morning, don't you say, oh, I have to go to the office, what's the time? The mind reminds, so, oh, I'll drive my car. And it creates millions and billions of impressions at every moment. And that is why we learn the first step is relax. Relax, steady, and happy moment. Why we did that? To help the mind to recognize, to become aware that when you do nothing, it doesn't trigger the body, it doesn't bring the past, then we deepen our experience in the second step by experiencing the sensation in the stillness that helped our mind to change the direction from outside to inside. Then we moved into the third step, what it really means by living in the present moment. What it really means by the mindfulness state here and now. As we understand, the mind has trillions of impressions. It has created its own world of pleasure, pain, hate, love, reaction, response. Do we need to control them? No. There comes the step of breath awareness. What the breath awareness does, there are more than 52 groups of practices of breath awareness, and every step of breath awareness has to be understood and we have to move into those 52 groups of breath awareness steps to reach to the highest state. Where is the highest state of awakening? What happens in awakening? Simple thing. You awaken to the peace, the happiness, wisdom, love. Where the stress and anxiety goes? That state of mindfulness changes the brain to change your attitude, behavior. It drops your reactions. It helps you to awaken to the responses. That is what happened as you were explaining to me. So what should be the ideal step? Breath awareness. We talk about, I'm mindful of the breath, but that doesn't work. How it works? When we qualify it. How do we qualify it? Let us see. Be into that state. You look at the breath. Breath is moving. So when you look at the breath, you become aware, your mind becomes aware that the breath is moving. Breath, moving. Moving breath. Moving breath. But you are also aware that you are not changing the rate and the rhythm of the breath. One more thing. How do you know the breath is moving? You feel the sensation. What should you do? Do nothing. Just look at the breath that is moving, one point. Look at the breath, you feel the sensation of the movement of the breath. That's a coordination, recognition, and also another subtle recognition that you're not changing the rate and the rhythm of the breath. Who changes? The mind. Who moves the breath on its own, the existence, the subjective reality, the subjective self? And we miss this part completely. So when we qualify the one step, one type of the breath awareness out of 52 steps, we recognize the breath is moving on its own, first point, feeling the sensation, second point, no change is the third point. So what happens? The mind continues to live within. Second thing, what happens? We experience the inward moving of the mind. Then what? That inward moving of the mind starts firing the brain to rewire it. Where I have to do nothing. After eating your food, you never say to your honey, let me sit. Why? I have to digest the food. Digestion happens on its own. Assimilation happens on its own. Look at it. Whatever you eat. Similarly, when you are aware of the breath, qualifying with the three points, it happens. What happens? It begins changing your brain. What should I do? Again, the mind asks, do nothing, my friend. No, but I have to maintain that state. Two things happen. When you are an advanced practitioner, this thought never comes to your mind that, oh, I have to maintain that state, I have to stay in that state for a longer period. Right? Now the mind is inward moving. There is a sense of self-absorption. So mind has no time to think, how much time I have to stay in that. When this mind doesn't think of the time, it also doesn't recognize any space. It also does not recognize any object. Where is that state? Total mindfulness. You have transcended the mind and you know it. We'll continue our journey of the mindfulness, understanding where it entails mindfulness practice.